Lossless Scaling can now triple your frame rate. Yes, you heard me right. The latest update allows for this frame generation technique to insert two extra frames instead of one. Lots of people got in contact to say, take a look. And actually, the update before this improved artifacting, so there's lots to look at here. I tested at 4K on my main system, 1080p on the low-end system, and I've used a camera recording at 120 frames per second so you can actually see what's going on. And I've also done some quick performance testing because this does increase GPU load. First of all, here we are at 4K going around Louisville on my 7800X3D system. We're trying to hit 48 frames per second here all the way around Louisville. The frame rate on the left is what is the native frame rate, and then you've got the frame generation frame rate on the right. So it should be tripled. You can't generate frames higher than your refresh rate, or you don't want to at least. So I've locked the frame rate to 48 FPS here, and we're targeting 144 frames, which is my monitor's refresh rate. So you'll see that we cannot maintain 48 FPS all the way around Louisville on this system. I went out to do a mission, and again, you can't necessarily always maintain 48 FPS in Star Citizen, even with a top-end system like this. But take a look at this footage here. I am in this battle here able to basically maintain 48 FPS. And I have to say, from playing it, this looked pretty great. This was always the best looking experience I've had in Star Citizen. Playing at 144 FPS looked pretty stunning. And the thing we always say about this is about input lag. You still have the input lag as if it was rendering at 48 FPS or around that at least. So it doesn't feel exactly like 144 FPS, but at 48, it's pretty decent. And this was quite impressive. Next up, we're going to use the camera. So we're going to record at 4K, 120 FPS, and then slow things down so you can see the smoothness. Now, in order to make this sort of work, we've locked the frame rate to 40 FPS, and we're using frame generation to then go up to 120 FPS. So in theory, this should all work. This first footage you'll see is at 25% speed. So we slowed this right down, and you'll see just how smooth the frame generation image on the right is. It really is significantly better, and you can see this isn't fake technology, this is really doing something. So we've inserted two extra frames per frame, and it's just much smoother than the image on the left. At 50% speed, you can still tell that it's much smoother. It's significantly better, three times better, some might say. And as we just look at the footage playing at full speed, you'll see that at this frame rate and this setup here, the artifacting isn't too bad. If you keep an eye on the map, there are occasional moments where it kind of flickers out of existence and does funny things. But on the whole, it's actually pretty good. And I think the improvements that have been coming with Lossless Scaling over the last few months do seem to have made a difference to the UI elements, at least. So they don't phase out of existence anywhere near as much. And they definitely seem to have improved the visual quality of this, as well as the obviously adding in the extra frames. But how does this work on a low-end system? We've got this system here. It's got an i7-8700, which is basically the same as my minimum spec CPU recommendation, the 10400. And it's got 32 gigs of RAM, and it's got a 1660 Ti. So a little bit above my minimum spec GPU recommendation. Starting off in the station here, you see the general problem with systems like this. There are occasional stutters and occasional bits where it just kind of, you're duplicating stuttery frames, and that's always been the case. But on the whole, it looks actually pretty decent. Again, we're recording 120 FPS, so you can't see this exactly on a YouTube video, but you get a rough idea of how this is working. In Louisville, the city, again, you see the issue with this. We can't maintain anywhere near 40 FPS on this system, so we are dropping way below that. But actually, the image still looks pretty good. We're still getting this 60, 50 FPS image. And yeah, when you slow it down here, you can see that there are problems. Again, the UI elements occasionally will flicker. But on the whole, it's actually pretty decent. As we slow it right down, again, big stutter there. There are issues definitely with the UI just kind of jolting out of existence when you're running at frame rates this low. It's not recommended to go this low, but this is Star Citizen after all. When we look at this at full speed, it looks pretty good. This is, if you were, I would be tempted on the lower end of the system to put up with the bigger kind of stutters and the visual quirkiness and take what looks like a quite a smooth experience. it really is quite impressive with the extra framing. I went on a mission though, and this does show where on the lower end systems it can become kind of unusable. I found my target here on the ground, and he's an AI target on the ground, so I thought, well, I'll just stay in the ship. But you'll see here by my very erratic movement and looking at the frame rate there, the game is quite hard to control at sub 20 FPS. And you'll see here as I try to aim, we're really dropping down to 14, 15, 16 FPS, and I cannot control this ship. And so even though the image looks nice and smooth, we're kind of at 50 FPS from the frame generated image, the controllability of the game is not great. And obviously that doesn't change. If I had no frame generation on here, it would still be uncontrollable. But you have to recognize the fact that making it look smoother doesn't make it feel smoother. And you'll see here as I horrendously try to take down this AI at sub 20 FPS, I just cannot, I can't stand up for a start, but I cannot control the gun in any way. It's really quite tricky at this lower frame rate. And again, the image looks quite good, but it's tricky to actually shoot. As I was leaving, a nice AI support ship comes in and starts shooting my ship. So this was fun. I've never actually seen this in-game happen before, but it allowed me to go up and do some space combat with this system. And once you're off the ground, it seems performance is better just in general here, but we're around the 30 FPS mark as we go through this fight. And as you'll see, it's not too bad. I can shoot, and again, it looks nice and smooth. We're in theory, this looks like 95 FPS, which is great, but it's as we slow down to 25% here, you'll see that it's quite a smooth image still, slowed down that much. And in this sort of use case, again, this is pretty good. Back up to full speed now, you'll see star citizen being star citizen as the guy explodes, but it kind of works on this system. But how much does this affect performance? So on this, again, low end system, you'll see here I've gone to the horizon roof, and this, just look at the GPU utilization. That's what we're looking at here. With no frame generation, we're around the 68, 75 mark. It bounces a bit between it. It's kind of going there. When we turn on 2x frame generation, we're up to around the 94, 90, 92% utilization. But then 3x utilization, we are slammed at 96%. It's basically maxed out here. So there are GPU considerations here. So depending on your system, depending on your GPU, what resolution you're playing, you may want to think about what is the best case to use here. There is a performance mode that they've now added, but to be fair, now that we've got upscaling with Star Citizen, potentially that will kind of mitigate any GPU issues like this. If you drop down your resolution with upscaling, you may find that you're not losing too much performance or losing any performance by using frame generation. So this program, this technology just keeps getting better and better. I've tested this now 3x and I'm more impressed every single time. If you've got this already, I would highly recommend trying out this new 3x version, because this, again, from a visual standpoint, from a smoothness point of view, this is the first time that in the cities I've played the game and it's obviously looked like 144 frames. Again, it doesn't feel exactly like that, and that's just on the main system, my top end system, but genuinely from a smoothness point of view, from that side of things, it looks great. And the artifacting is pretty minimal. It's getting better and better compared to when we've looked at the past, where it was a bit all over the place. And even on the low end system, the mileage will vary for you. I think on this you might be hypersensitive to the more artifacting that will appear, I think, with lower frame rates. And also the stutters are kind of more exaggerated because you're generating the frames for the stuttered frames and all that sort of stuff, or at least it just doesn't look great when it stutters. But there will be parts of the game on a low system like this, the roughly minimum spec system that I used here, where again you're getting the visual smoothness of a much higher end system on a really low end system. So I would say for most people, this is definitely worth checking out now. And again, we will get frame generation at some stage, I'm sure, natively in Star Citizen. I'm sure you can obviously already use AMD's fluid motion frames in there. And I'm sure we will get Nvidia's frame generation at some stage. And I would be pretty surprised if AMD and Nvidia don't also copy this technology and allow for a for an extra frame to be generated so you can triple frames, because it seems to work pretty well here. So yeah, good stuff, and I would recommend checking it out.